The circumference of a sphere was measured to be 76 centimeters with a possible error of 0.5 centimeters. We want to use a linear approximation to estimate the maximum error in calculating the surface area. Because we're using a linear approximation, we'll be using differentials, which uses the change of y along the tangent line rather than the change of y of the actual function. And then we'll also find the relative error in calculating the surface area. Let's begin by reviewing the formulas that we need. The surface area of a sphere is equal to 4 pi r squared, and the circumference of a circle, which should be the perimeter of the circle, is equal to pi times d, or 2 pi r. So again, the surface area of a sphere is equal to 4 pi r squared, and the circumference of a circle is equal to 2 pi r. Now, because we're looking for the error in the surface area, and we're using a linear approximation, we're going to use differential s to calculate this maximum error. Where differential s would be equal to the derivative of 4 pi r squared with respect to r times dr. So again, differential s, which should be the error in the surface area, would be equal to 8 pi r times differential r. But notice how the error deals with the measurement of the circumference, where the error is plus or minus 0.5 centimeters. So this tells us that delta C, or differential C, is equal to plus or minus 0.5 centimeters. But notice to find differential S, we need R and differential R, not differential C. So if we take our circumference formula, C equals 2 pi R, and we divide both sides by 2 pi, notice that r is equal to the circumference divided by 2 pi. And therefore, if differential C is equal to plus or minus 0.5 centimeters, then it follows that differential r must be equal to plus or minus 0.5 centimeters divided by 2 pi. So we'll be using this to find differential S and this to find differential S. Where our differential S is equal to 8, which I'm going to write as 8 over 1, times pi times r. But notice that r is equal to the circumference divided by 2 pi, where the circumference is 76 centimeters. So r is 76 divided by 2 pi. And then for differential r, we'll have plus or minus 0.5 divided by 2 pi. This product will give us the error when calculating the surface area if the error in measuring the circumference is plus or minus 0.5 centimeters. Notice one factor of pi simplifies out, and then 2 times 2 would be 4. That simplifies with the 8, so these two simplify to 1, and the 8 simplifies to 2. So that leaves us with differential S is equal to 2 times 76 times plus or minus 0.5 divided by pi. And this does deal with surface area, so this would be centimeters squared. Let's get our decimal approximation for this using the calculator. So the numerator is going to be 2 times 76 times 0.5, and divide this by pi. Let's go around this to four decimal places. This would be approximately 24.1916 square centimeters. Which means the possible error when determining the surface area is plus or minus 24.1916 square centimeters. Now let's determine the relative error when calculating the surface area. The relative error would be equal to differential S divided by S. The relative error would be equal to differential S divided by S, or the error in determining the surface area divided by the surface area. So differential s was, again, 8 pi r times dr, and the surface area is equal to 4 pi r squared. Let's go and simplify this, then we'll make our substitutions. So notice 8 and 4 share a common factor of 4. There's 1 4 and 4 and 2 4s and 8. The pi simplify to 1, and also 1 factor of r simplifies out. This simplifies to 1, this simplifies to r to the first. So the relative error would be equal to 2 times differential r divided by r. So we'd have 2 times, again, differential r was plus or minus 0.5 divided by 2 pi, and r was equal to 76 divided by 2 pi. These two pi's would simplify out, and 2 times plus or minus 0.5 would be plus or minus 1. So this simplifies to plus or minus 1 divided by 76. Let's go ahead and get a decimal approximation. 1 divided by 76 is approximately 0.0132. Again, this would be plus or minus. If we were asked to convert this to a percentage, we have to multiply by 100 and add a percent sign. So this would be equal to, 1.32%, or plus or minus 1.32%. I hope you found this helpful.